kids, Pete from Mid Central here. I thought we'd have a quick chat about legends, tales, myths, secret societies, hiding secrets for ages and ages, things buried out in the middle of nowhere, crazy stuff like that. What if I told you millions of dollars of Atari product had been dumped in a landfill in New Mexico? Now, I don't know if your friends are like my friends, but if your friends are like my friends, all of us are going to be hitting up the curbside check-in at the local airport because we're all heading out to New Mexico. Let's go. Atari product? Are you kidding me? Thousands and thousands of cartridges and prototypes, hardware, all kinds of crazy stuff loaded into 10 semis dumped in a landfill? Yeah, let's go look for that. Let's go take a look for that. I mean, come on, that sounds like a great thing. Isn't that just sort of what dreams and too much beer kind of make us do? I mean, it does sound cool. I mean, isn't that basically the Atari legend? They had all this extra product, and they had to get rid of it, and they put it into a landfill. A company came along and said they were going to do just that and make a documentary film about it. This was about a year ago, last May, June, somewhere in there. Company Fuel Industries came out and said, hey, we're going to go dig up this landfill and find all this Atari products. It's like, wow, isn't that basically what I've been dying for those two guys on Mythbusters to do? Maybe? They've debunked everything else on the planet. Why not the Atari landfill rumor? Come on, put that one to rest. Doesn't that sound cool? As a rabid fan of all things Atari, I would love for this legend to be true. I mean, I've talked about it with friends over beers endless times, and it just is like the coolest thing ever. But let's sort of take that devil's advocate approach to this, because there are a few things that don't add up. At a landfill, you cannot drive 10 trucks of anything into a landfill and just like dump them and just sort of not leave a trace. I mean, there's a lot of paperwork involved. There are a lot of people involved. There's a lot of stuff involved that would leave a trail. Never have I heard of anyone saying that they have documentation as to when it happened, where it was buried, and how the you know, there are a lot of things to this. You can't just go in and dump stuff. Landfills are kind of like little science projects. They have different areas for different types of waste that you're getting rid of. And sometimes landfills deal with hazardous waste. And because of that, they're actually quite highly regulated. So you don't just drive trucks and trucks and trucks of stuff in there, dump them in the middle of the night, and sneak away like, shh, nobody saw us. Because I don't care if anyone saw you, you left a lot of paperwork behind. So don't you think, I mean, if nothing else, I mean, Atari is so iconic, and they've been iconic for decades. I mean, even in the mid-80s, everybody was like, Atari, you know? You didn't play video games, you played Atari. It was a thing. It was like a Google or a Kleenex or a Xerox. It was a product name that had become a thing unto itself because they were so popular. So I don't care really, you know, what kind of like secrecy disclosure documents you may have signed. At some point, someone who drove a whole semi full of Atari stuff into a landfill and dumped it is going to be talking about that story. If nothing else, don't you think it'd be like someone's drunken uncle at a Thanksgiving dinner? Did I tell you about the time I drove a whole truck full of E.T. the extraterrestrial into a landfill? Yes, you know, actually you do tell us that story every Thanksgiving, and you know it sounds an awful lot like a story that I've heard. Was that in New Mexico by any chance? I mean, you can't really hide something like that. There's a lot to it. Here's the other problem I have. And I really want this to be true. I don't mean to be a little Debbie Downer here, but everything I understand about this project, I have learned from watching Gold Rush. You watch Gold Rush, Discovery Channel? You know, Hoffman crew, Parker Schnabel, all these guys out here gold mining, and they have this reality show around it. Well, basically, they're using a lot of tools of the trade that one might use to dig up a landfill. Let's just have a quick refresher on what you do if you're gold mining. So basically, you have some excavators, and they're digging up dirt from wherever they feel the gold-rich dirt is. They're putting them into trucks that transport it to what they call a wash plant. Now, the wash plant is where you throw all of your dirt, and it basically separates it by size. Gets rid of the big boulders, the rocks and stuff, and just sort of brings it all down to at the very end, you have your sort of like, hopefully a lot of nuggets, but, you know, microscopic pieces of gold. Because the gold is very tiny compared to all the other stuff you're digging up. So, basically, you have these two processes going on. You got guys that are digging up dirt, moving it to this plant, and people who are operating the plant that separate all this stuff out. And basically, this whole process, you know, obviously it's been refined since the gold rush days of a century ago and so forth, but they have equipment for this. Now, if you're out in the landfill, full of garbage, and you dig up a scoop of something with your excavator, how do you know the garbage you've dug up is Atari garbage or just some other garbage? Because I'm pretty sure these guys don't know where to dig. Nowhere have I read that anyone has a map, a GPS coordinate, or has anything that would lead me to believe that they know where to dig. So basically, it sounds like they're going to go in and just start digging up and see if they can find it. The whole thing has been, we're going to see if we can find that stuff. And when you look at the acreage that the average landfill has, I mean, they can be hundreds of acres. So if you're just digging, I mean, you're just never going to find... I mean, even people who are, like, mining for gold, they look at geological features around the area to try and figure where they think the gold track would be and the best place to dig. You can't do that with random Atari product thrown into a landfill. That makes it very difficult. And, as I say, you get that big scoopful of garbage. How do you find out what's Atari garbage and what's just garbage? I mean, you're not going to see Atari logos flutter out like butterflies at some really bad wedding. I mean, how do you tell what you got? And then let's just look at what you might get. I mean, what if they did know? Maybe they're not putting out this information because they don't want people to know that they know and will get the coordinates and go out there and dig it up for us or blah, blah, blah. Who knows? But whatever. Say they do find this stuff. What are they really going to find? A plastic card. You take a card. I mean, this is an Activision card, and it's got the typical Activision label. It looks all kinds of funky, like it's been buried in the dirt. But basically, your label's going to be gone. You know, that's just not going to happen. You know, this stuff's been out there 30 years in the dirt. What's going to be left? And it was allegedly crushed first. So I think at best you might find black plastic. But finding black plastic in the middle of a large landfill is kind of that needle in a haystack thing. And the latest thing I read, actually, which was actually just today, one of the guys who's part of this whole thing apparently is at South by Southwest, and they were talking about it, and he said, basically in closing, we're going to keep digging until we find it. Because, you know, the big thing is, what if you don't find it? And the answer to that is never, well, we know exactly where to dig, no worries. No, they say things like, we're going to dig until we find it. I'm pretty sure this project has a budget. And you're not going to dig until you find it, because, one, there are hundreds of acres you could be digging through, and let's have a discussion about the price of diesel fuel. I'm pretty sure you'll chug your way through your budget probably in about, I don't know, what, 3 to 4 weeks, maybe? And then to discover that this documentary is part of some Microsoft thing. Microsoft is funding this, and it's going to be part of their Xbox entertainment platform where they deliver compelling movies to people who like to play Xbox and basically were born 15 years after Atari went away and have never played Atari, seen Atari. They've heard of Atari, they've heard of Pong, not sure what it is, never played it, but they've heard of all this stuff. But why would Microsoft be so interested in it? I don't know. It's almost like a sort of the whole, you know, Al Capone's vault kind of a thing. You know, what are we going to find? There's going to be like this big intrigue, because I'm sure that's the reason. But a lot of things really bother me about this project. And again, in closing, I hope that they find something, because that would be the coolest thing ever. I mean, regardless of the legend and solving it and so forth, but just to know that that really did happen, and then someone came back like 30 years later and found it, that's awesome. So, we'll see what happens. Keep it retro. Go dig around your own backyard. You might find black plastic out there, too. But it's probably going to be shards from a potted plant that your mom had. But still, keep it retro anyway, and keep the faith.